Kovchek presents. Like a bent bow, horizon attracts travelers. The bowstring is drawn again, and the arrow of the expedition flies to faraway lands. Now it has found Mangystau. Mangystau, the Kingdom of Urial. Continuing the exploration of the animal world, the team of the Ark Ecological Center arrived to Mangystau at the Utsurt Plateau. Edward Monikans and Podion Buchkuri try to look into the secrets of animal paths of West Kazakhstan. The Ark had been traveling across the space of the Utsurt Plateau before in different modes. There had been trophy drives with seasoned jeepers, and solitary voyages, and travels with companies of friends. The team often met urials. Within Kazakhstan, Trans-Caspian urials inhabit chinks, a local name for cliff walls forming the border of the plateaus, and also seashore cliffs and low mountains along the eastern shore of the Caspian Sea and on the Mangishlak Peninsula. These mammals, belonging to the sheep genus, revived the severe landscape of Mangystau. They usually kept significant distance from people, not letting us closer. It was interesting to get an insight of their world, observe behavior, and learn about their neighbors. The end of autumn is probably the best time for such observations, when urials are in rut. Having organized a purposeful expedition for setting up a number of video traps, the ARC team passed through labyrinths of eternity, surrounded by grandiose landscapes, and arrived to Utsurt, to a sacred place called Beket Ata. It is a shrine of the Mangystau, where under protection of heavenly patronage, animals feel themselves more secure and are less afraid of the people. The work of setting up the traps started. For each of them, an appropriate and secluded place had to be chosen, where the chance of filming animals would be the highest. After this task had been completed, we had nothing to do but wait. Staying in Utsurt for some time, the Ark decided to film its awesome landscapes. However, the process of aerial filming is so fascinating that one can easily forget about technical limitations of the aircraft. And that's exactly what happened.
После залета за скалу пропал сигнал, аппарат включил автовозврат домой, перехват управления оказался запоздалым, и он успел по пути назад строго в эту скалу и воткнуться. Ну, извини. Пошли ремонтироваться.
Luckily, our 8-propeller cruiser, a self-made drone constructed by Edward, is maximally maintainable. And after just 2 hours, it rose up into the skies again, in order to deliver the epic scale of the area, this time from the bird's eye view. Half a year had passed, and the ARC team returned to Ustyurt to their video traps. Already the first one shocked the researchers. Not with its outstanding footage, but with its enigmatic disappearance.
Мы на первой точке. Погодь, я камеру не вижу. Погрешность метров 10.
Evidently, someone had found it and nicked it. It wasn't as offensive to lose the trap as to never learn what it had filmed.
Нашел я камень, где раньше стояла камера, и камни, которые маленькие, его подпирали. Рядом ничего нет.
The next trap didn't add joy. It had been obviously knocked down by somebody. But this somebody didn't take away the camera. Later, when we checked the footage, we understood who and why.
То, что они украли, уже хорошо.
Animals paid specific attention to this trap. And even got nervous. Until one courageous Urial male solved the problem in a radical way. Fortunately, all other traps remain intact.
Невероятно. Камера на самом видном месте, и её не обнаружили. Это большая радость.
It gave some chance to look into the enigmatic world of animal paths of Mangystau. So researchers started checking the footage. Unfortunately, all the traps provided quite ordinary and not very informative shots. It was obvious that urials and other animals were quite common there, but nothing more. The sum of all the circumstances, the disappearance of one camera, another one knocked down, and very average footage, plunged the team into despondency. It was decided to wrap up and admit defeat. Since a lot of time was left till the planned end of the expedition, the ARC team, together with their Kazakhstan friends, went on a trip across the bottom of the Thetis Ocean on their land cruiser. Just one trap was left for checking. And an incredible thing happened. It filmed a mysterious cat, reminiscent of a leopard. It was next to impossible, because there are no leopards in Mangystau since long ago. But theoretically, and even in reality, they sometimes wander into Kazakhstan from neighboring Turkmenistan. This footage changed the whole situation. Obviously, further observations were necessary. Next autumn, researchers from the Ecologic Center, the Ark, once again went to Mangystau, to the Kingdom of Urial. Now, they relied not just upon traps, but on manual video cameras with powerful optical zoom as well. Having set up the traps, researchers immersed in observations. Splendid Urial males could be seen during the rut. Their horns, with distinct transverse grooves, are curved back, down, and forth, and form a full curl or even more. These lookers displayed persistent interest for females. Females didn't accept their courtship willingly, but rams didn't give up. Each one of them joined a group of several ewes, consistently paying attention to every one of them, simultaneously watching out so that his females wouldn't be distracted by other males. Every ram considered himself irresistible and the only one worth attention. It was interesting to watch not only Urial behavior, but also observe foxes, not quite afraid of people. Such abundance of wild animals gave hope of solving the mystery of the appearance of the leopard there. But we had to wait half a year, till next spring. Once again, the Ark is in Ustyurt. Researchers are overwhelmed by mixed emotions. They are full of hopes. It's a mixture of delight, excitement, presentiment of sensation, and fear of disappointment. Having collected all the traps, researchers with impatience started looking through the material. This time, it was much more interesting and proved that without video traps, it would be impossible to obtain it. It became all clear about the leopard. It appeared to be the steppe cat that had been filmed by our traps several times before. The sensation about the leopard didn't happen. But another sensation did happen, and one that nobody could dream about. A trap set up in a promising place produced the first in history of scientific research footage of Turkmen Karakal. Turkmen Karakal, or desert lynx, is a very rare animal, with total numbers are estimated at no more than 300. But in Kazakhstan, only singular encounters have been recorded. This animal had never been filmed on video. Now that was a real sensation. And a reason for further research.